looks like we're going to have about 15 to 25 minutes before our first half marathoners come through. Gord Pauls, can you come to the finish area? Gord or Leanne? Leanne, can you please come to the finish area? Gord? Of noteworthy things happening today. We have a gentleman who is bib number 100, who's actually running his 100th marathon today. We also have a young 17-year-old who will be, his name is Colin Hayes. He'll be dribbling a basketball through the whole marathon, believe it or not. He figures it'll be anywhere between 30 and 38,000 dribbles during the marathon. So that'll be something neat to see come through. We're also going to have a visit from Reed Coolsack and Eric Gillis, two of our Canadian Olympians now. The first two Canadian Olympians to actually qualify for the marathon since 1980, believe it or not. We haven't had anyone in the marathon in the Olympics since then. And now we're going to have two. They qualified just last month with great times. Actually, believe it or not, Eric qualified with only 1 second to spare. So he just made it. So I'll be announcing some of the folks coming through the finish area today. I'll also have some trivia for you. I'll also give you some facts about Hamilton and the history of Hamilton. It's a great community. About 11 o'clock today, we're going to have a band also playing over by the stage to the east side of the event center here. They'll be playing some Beatles tunes, from what I understand, and I hear they're great, great band. Thank you.
all set.
If you want, there's some charities selling coffee and hot apple cider and some chili. So if you want to warm up, they're just by the third tent on the east side of the events grounds here. A little tidbit of information, and on this day in 1917, New York State became the first state in the U.S. to allow women to vote. This day, 1917. if things go good, looks like we'll be about 10 more minutes until the first half marathoners come through. Thank you.
Everybody on your dick, no homo. I bought my whole family whips, no fobos. Next time I'm in church, please, no photos. Police escorts, everybody passports. This the life that everybody asks for. This a fast life, we are on a crash course. What you think I rap for? To push a fucking rap for? But I know that if I stay stunting, all these girls only gon' want one thing. I could spend my whole life goodwill hunting. Only good gon' come, this is good when I'm coming. She got an ass that'll swallow up a G-string. And up top, two police things. And I'm beasting off the re-sling. And my niggas just made it out the precinct. We give a damn about the drama that you do bring. I'm just trying to take the color on your mood ring. Reebok, baby, you need to try some new things. Have you ever had shoes without shoestrings? What's that, yay? Baby, these heels. Is that a made what? Baby, these wheels. You tripping when you ain't sipping. Have a refill. You're feeling like you're running, huh? Now you know how we feel. Hey.
All right, I'd like to mention some of the great sponsors who have helped us out today and help us put this on. Brooks Canada, of course, they're the footwear and apparel running company. Popeyes, also Popeyes the supplement folks. And of course, Empower Global, who's our title sponsor. And family here today watching your family come through or your friends, and I just wanted to mention that the this gentleman here taking pictures at the finish, and they're called mysportsshooter.com, and makes for a great Christmas gift, I would say. So if you want to sneak a shot of your family member coming through the finish, I think that's a great idea for Christmas. So, and again, they're called mysportsshooter.com. That's who you can go to. Here's a little bit more trivia for you today. Can anybody tell me who this great city of Hamilton is named after? Does anybody know? His last name was Hamilton. Does anybody know the first name? You win a free vacation to Bolton. All right, his name was George Hamilton. This was back in the 1600s, believe it or not. He came here and took over some land. But Hamilton has a great tradition of being doers. I know there's a lot of you from Hamilton here today, and of course, and I have to say, I'm not from Hamilton, but I definitely admire Hamiltonians. The race directors of this event, Gordon, Esther, Pauls, are such giving people that you cannot help but have respect for them. This event has only been in existence for about 5 years, and over that time has raised over $1 million for charity. There are races in the U.S. and Canada, for that matter, that have 40, 50,000 participants who do not raise that much money. So kudos off to the race directors here, the owners of Runner's Den here in Hamilton's best running shop. Also, some of the charitable organizations involved with this this race: Empower Global, who's the title sponsor. They are based here out of the Hamilton area, and they do some great work down in Bangladesh and in Haiti. Do we have our first runner coming through? Yeah, it looks like we do, folks. Here he comes. All right, he's battling the wind, folks. Here he comes. Looks like we're going to be... Here we go. Put your hands together. All right, he's all by himself. Who do we have coming through? All right, it's Victor from Hamilton. Way to go, Victor! That's Victor Katundu from Hamilton. Bib number 1622. And he is all by himself. Looks like there'll be more than a minute or so behind for second place. Comes some more runners. Two more. This is a battle for second and third place. Here's a good finish coming up. All right, we've got even the fourth place finisher coming through. All right. Looks like in second place will be Kevin Moore of St. Catharines. Way to go, Kevin! And in third place, Evans. Evans McKeel from Hamilton. Way to go. Fourth place, Stephen Miller from Burlington. All right, looks like it's a local affair. Hamilton, St. Catharines, Hamilton, and Burlington. Way to go, guys. As I was saying earlier, Hamilton is full of great people, I think. There's two great organizations that are will be the beneficiaries of the proceeds today. One of them is City Kids. City Kids is an organization that does amazing work here at home. Unfortunately, one in four children live at or below the poverty line, and they are the ones that are doing the hard work for us here in the community. So hats off to City Kids. And the Joint Hope of Haiti is the other organization that is based here out of Hamilton and does incredible work down in Haiti. I know they've built over 20 schools in Haiti. All right, looks like our fifth place overall is coming through. So fifth place in the half marathon is Nathan Mudge from Sault Ste. Marie. All right. We got some Sault Ste. Marieers coming through. All right, Dan. That's number five. I did a little bit of research on Hamilton too, and I saw that that goodwill kind of stretched way back into the 1800s. You know what happened here in Hamilton, and what Hamiltonians gave this country of ours? Well, there was a march in the 1800s, in the 1850s, called the 9-Hour Movement. Anybody heard about that? 9-Hour Movement? Well, this was laborers, believe it or not, they were lobbying for a 9-hour work day. Because they used to work 10 to 12 hours a day, and, well, they wanted to spend some time with their families. So that march led to Sir John A. Macdonald, our first Prime Minister, enacting the Trade Union Act. All right, number six coming through in the half marathon. It's Taylor from Hamilton. Way to go, Taylor. These are pretty quick times. Looks like we haven't even hit 1:16 yet. You are 7th overall, coming through. All right. 7th overall in the 2011 half marathon is Alistair Munro from Toronto. Talking a lot about Hamilton today, giving you a little bit of history about the area. Did you know today, on this day in 1988, at another marathon, the New York Marathon, Greta White, everybody hear of her? She's one of the greatest marathoners of all time. She won her 9th title. All right, number 8 coming through is Tyler Lord from Oakville. Way to go, Tyler! Yeah, Greta Weiss was an amazing marathoner. 1988, on this day, she won her 9th New York Marathon. Incredible. All right, we got a battle for 9th and 10th spot. It's gonna come right down to the wire. All right, Cass and Chris from London. All right, here comes Michael from Brooklyn. Way to go, Michael. And Larry Bradley from Mississauga. Way to go, Larry. These are all great times, all under 1:30. And Hugo from Toronto. Way to go, Hugo. Some of our media sponsors today are CHCH. They've got a tent set up and they're handing out water, I believe, today. Did we get an official time on that, on the finisher, on the half? All right, we've got a few more people coming through, and it looks like you're going to come in under 1:30, of course. This is great time. Good, strong finish. get charged to the end. James. James from Toronto and Ken from Waterloo. Coming through. And here comes Martin Kastner from Montreal. All right. Here's our first out of province runner coming through, and Anthony Davey from Toronto. Way to go, Anthony. And Carson Nemo from Aurora. Way to go. Great time, excellent time, under 120. All right, we just have word that the winning time was 1:10:54, which is a great time. This wind might have played a role in today's time. All right, good strong finish. Way to go, Randy. And Randy's from Ottawa. Give it up for Ottawa, folks. All right. The record time for the Hamilton Half Marathon was in 2007 by Pius Poirier from Kenya, who did this in 104.59. All right, here comes Christian from Ottawa, another Ottawa, two in a row, way to go. And this is our first female. All right, Carrie Cook from Ottawa, way to go, Carrie! Good job. Kevin Farr from Port Dover. Way to go, Kevin. All right, Peter Ching from Toronto. Way to go, Peter. Got quite a few runners coming through now. Good strong finish for John from London. Jeff from Moonstone, all right. And Patrick from Hamilton, way to go. John Connors from Hamilton, way to go, John. And Elias from Toronto, Alistair from London, Scott from Toronto.